While Fme Workbench does not allow you to inspect the data, it is closely integrated with Fme's viewing application, Fme Data Inspector. If you select Run with Full Inspection from the menu bar, you will notice the highlighted feature counts on each connection port. These are links to versions of the data saved at these points. You could double-click on any of the bubbles to open the data in the Fme Data Inspector. If you want to view the data that was actually written by the translation, you may right-click on the destination feature type and select Inspect. This shows us how Data Inspector is closely tied to Workbench. But of course, we may also open Data Inspector at any time from the Start menu. Fme Data Inspector can be found alongside the other Fme tools within your Windows Start menu. I can start the inspection process in Fme Data Inspector by using the Open Dataset tool on the menu bar. Notice the Open Dataset dialog is very similar to the dialogs for creating a translation in Fme Workbench. Here I will inspect a map info dataset of parks located in the city of Vancouver. For my dataset, I will navigate to my parks folder located within my Fme data file, and I will select my parks.tab dataset. When I click OK, the data will appear in the main window of the Fme Data Inspector. I can also add more data to the view in any supported format. For example, here I will add a roads dataset, this time by dragging and dropping it directly into the Data Inspector. Now that we have opened some data, notice that there are four key windows in the Data Inspector. In the center is a large display window. This is where data can be inspected spatially. Windowing tools on the toolbar allow me to zoom and pan into the features I want to see. On the left-hand side of the Data Inspector is a window for controlling features in the display. Within this window, I can change the order of layers by dragging one layer above another, turn layers on and off, or simply change the colors that features are displayed in. When I click on a feature in the display window, information about it is returned in the feature information window. Here I can see general information about a feature, such as the coordinate system, accuracy attributes, and information about the feature's geometry. If I want to browse attribute information for all features in my dataset, Table View window lets me do that. Notice that there is a separate tab for each table or layer in my data. And just like that, we've viewed data in the Fme Data Inspector and taken a tour of its key functionality. Now, we also learned another very important lesson, which is that we can transfer data from Fme Workbench at any point during translation. That's pretty impressive if you're asking me. That's if you're asking me. Anyway, thanks so much for joining me, and until next time, happy FMEing!